sitting at Fanny's of the Week. My name is Ellen. It is literally week 10 of me forgetting my tripod. Welcome to week 10. The owners of the shop are sitting here doing actual work while I eat a Mexican pastry. Me and this Mexican pastry will be reviewing this 1922 Vega Banjolin.
The pastry, you're just happy to see me.
I was going to review a Yamaha Guitarlele, but then I bought it. So we got this weird hybrid instrument instead. While I get this thing tuned up, let me tell you a little bit about banjolins and hybrid instruments in general. Actually, let me just wait until I'm done tuning. In the early 20th century, before electrified instruments, people were trying to figure out how to get their instruments to be louder. And they succeeded with this thing. There were also mandolin orchestras and banjo bands. God help us, there were banjo bands. They were trying to get people who played mandolin in the banjo bands. I don't know, it was the 20s, they didn't have as much to do as we have now. Today, the term banjolin can refer to mandolin banjo hybrids or violin banjo hybrids, 4 or 8 strings. Also, banjolin is just more fun to say than mando banjo. And let's take a look at the word banjo, shall we? B-A-N-G-O. And banjo was his name. It's a really weird word if you look at it for a long time. What is a J doing in there? What? Just look at the word banjo. Oh, okay. It is quite loud, and that is the primary tonal characteristic. Woo! Let's get out the... Oh. Can't use the decibel meter because my phone is the camera and it's over there. If you need to be the loudest thing at the bluegrass jam, this is the instrument you need. Here we go. And a one, and a two. Have you ever heard a more horrible sound in your life? It can also make a very pretty sound if you play it more gently. But it's not dust, and I can't really get it off. Wait, that reminds me of a song. Might be a little dust on a banjo. I'll let it fool you about what's inside. There's nothing inside. It's empty. It's a banjo. This part is pretty, and this part is loud. We have the appropriate headgear for playing this instrument, and I shall return forthwith. Should you choose to purchase this Vega Banjolin from us, we may also give you these Vic Firth kid phones, which are designed for babies at loud concerts, but would also do with guitar store employees with a banjolin. Oh, yeah. I can assure you I'm having a much more pleasant experience now that I've donned these. I've also just now realized that as an involuntary reaction to wearing these headphones, I just shout.
Shout more.
I shout more. That's good. Oh, yeah. Oh, my God. Do not play this instrument without wearing proper ear protection. I give it 3 out of 5 ounces.
Ellen!
Here at Fanny's House of Music, we also sell vintage clothing. For the person who needs an outfit as loud as their banjolin, we have this 2-piece electric gold suit. Thank you very much. They're saying no.
Your wife, John.
Oh, you're right. Dang. I feel like C-3PO. I would imagine you have to wear different footwear than white athletic socks. It's actually not entirely uncomfortable. I sure don't have too much to say about this. Thank you for watching Ellen's Favorite Thing at Fanny's of the Week. Tune in next week for me to have another favorite thing.